Welcome back, my friends, to another edition of Cook Your Catch on Friedman Adventures with Chef Jason. The days of looking at bonito as if it were a trash fish are long gone. Here's a great recipe for smoked bonito.
Welcome to another edition of How to Cook Your Catch. I'm Chef Jason from Shoal Law Beach. Today we're going to be doing a recipe showing you how to smoke your catch. The first thing we're going to talk about is your smoker. I personally like to use an electric smoker. It allows you to keep the temperature low enough and get your fish smoky enough without overcooking it. All right, so the first step in this recipe is you want to start with your brine. Brine is very important. It's going to add flavor to your fish as well as adding sugar to it, which will keep it moist. So the first thing you want to start off with some warm water. You're going to add brown sugar and salt. Onion powder, garlic powder. And all fish is good with some lemon. From there, we're going to whisk to combine. We did start off with warm water so that everything will dissolve quicker. And that's your brine. And you're going to want to let it sit to go to room temperature before you use it. All right, next step in this process is talking about the fish. Today we're using Bonito. A lot of people think this has a bad rap, that it's mushy, but I'm here to tell you, if you take care of it, you bleed it, you put it on ice, it's a great fish to use, not only for smoking, but also for sushimi and other dishes as well. So the first step with this is we're gonna break this fish down. This should be what it looked like when you got it off the boat. When you got it home, you take it out of the bag, you wanna rinse it off. There usually is going to be a piece of skin here that is so fish and game knows what kind of fish it is. Now we're going to want to get rid of the bloodline as well as all the bones. So we'll split it. You can see the bloodline right here. And what I like to do is get my knife under the bloodline and slice it out. Take your time doing this and make sure you get all of the bloodline out. And from there, you can split it into whatever portions you'd like to have. And you can trim up any of the pieces that don't look nice. So now that you have your fish trimmed to your desired size, you're gonna now put it in the brine that is at room temperature. All right, now that you have your fish in your brine, you're gonna wanna put it in the refrigerator. You're gonna wanna brine this between 6 and 24 hours. It's all gonna depend on how big the fish pieces are. And how much flavor you want to impart in them. All right, now that your fish is done brining to the consistency that you would like, you're going to take it from its brine, you're going to rinse it well, we're going to pat dry, and you're going to put it on your racks. All right, so now that you have your fish on your rack, the next goal is to get a pellicle. What a pellicle is, it's drying out the outside of the fish, and it also works for meat. It makes the smoke stick to the fish a lot quicker, and it'll give you a better smoke quality. So what we'll do is we'll take this, we'll put it into the fridge, uncovered. You can also put a fan to blow over it, but you'll wanna let it sit for at least 1 hour to 4 hours so that the top dries out. All right, now that we've removed our fish from the refrigerator after 1 hour to 4 hours and we have a nice pellicle on it, we're gonna fill our smoker. What you're gonna wanna do is start off with your largest portions of fish, and you're gonna start at the top and fill, and you're going to progressively work your way down with smaller and smaller pieces. From there, you're just going to want to close your smoker. And add your wood chips. And these are apple wood. All right, so now that your first pan is done after about half an hour, you're gonna wanna take a look at your fish just to see if you need to rotate it all. If all the fish are the same size, you may need to rotate your bottom racks to your top racks. So once again, we're gonna close it back up. And we'll add our second pan to our smoker. It should take about a half an hour to finish as well. All right, so now that your fish is done smoking, when you pull it out, it should look something like this. Now, depending on how long you smoke it for and how long you want it to last, you may want to cook it longer or shorter. It may be darker or lighter, but this should be what your product looks like. So now your fish is done smoking and is at room temperature, you can either go ahead and eat it, or you can use it in one of our other recipes. And we have a recipe here for you. It's gonna be for smoked fish dip. So this is the same product we just finished with, but we pulsed it in a Robocoup or a food processor. From here, what we're gonna do is this is gonna be cream cheese. We're gonna add our cream cheese. We're gonna add a cup of mayo. We have some Dijon mustard. Some Worcestershire sauce. I'm sure someone's gonna say I said it wrong. I say it how it's spelled. Old Bay seasoning. Chopped parsley. Always gonna add a little bit of hot sauce. Or a lot of hot sauce. And from there, we're gonna add a little bit of citrus. And then you're gonna mix to combine. And once it's thoroughly combined, you can plate it and eat it with crackers. So now that you've combined all the ingredients, it should look something like this. And for this, it is very simple plating. I like to use an ice cream scoop. You take a nice fat scoop, put it in your bowl. Sprinkle it with a bit of green onions, a little more Old Bay for some color, and then we serve it with some Ritz crackers. And if you want to dip in, wonderful.
Man, oh man, was that a tasty recipe. Make sure you check out all of Chef Jason's great recipes right here on Friedman Adventures or visit him at Shoals in Long Beach. Take care, my friends. Bon appetit.